This presentation introduces Scientific Foresight's added value in the European Parliament. In particular, it focuses on the methodology we proposed in the guidelines published in January 2015. Such a methodology is represented as a key in guiding policymakers in their parliamentary activities, with the final aim of opening the padlock that is keeping science apart from policy and politics. In 2013, the European Parliament Research Service, EPRS, was established as the in-house think tank to provide high-level advice to MEPs. Within this framework, the Science and Technology Assessment Options, STOA, assesses issues with a scientific and technological dimension, providing specialist and independent options in the policy sectors concerned. Specifically, the Scientific Foresight Unit engages with emerging concerns about what effects techno-scientific innovations could have in the long term. Details on how we take up this challenge are provided by the publication entitled Towards Scientific Foresight for the European Parliament, which has been submitted to a peer-reviewed journal. Before we look into emerging techno-scientific trends, it's relevant to consider lessons learned from the past and present developments. Let's look into the past and consider some of today's technologies from a 20-year-ago perspective. 20 to 25 years ago, a telephone was fixed on the wall in your home or office. No plug, you even had to stay in the same room to call. To date, phones have been developing not only into much smaller portable devices, but also up to a point in which smartphones have almost endless functions. This evolution was the basis for both societal and economic revolutions. It had an enormous impact on economic growth, as new markets and new services were created. It also has societal repercussions, since life seems faster now, and we are reachable all the time. One might see such developments in an overall positive light. Yet, what happened to the right to be unavailable in our private life? These new technologies are designed with the purpose to improve our quality of life by, for instance, saving us time. However, smartphones arguably did the opposite. Some of us have less free time and are always connected and available for work. Along with the positive effects of technology, there are negative effects too. Negative societal impacts of technology can be divided into hard and soft impacts. While hard impacts are well known and easier to imagine, technology's soft impacts are more difficult to recognize. The soft impacts of technology do not necessarily pose tangible harm, such as health issues, which can be measured in terms of numbers. The link between cause and effect is blurry, which makes it difficult to determine who is responsible for possible impacts and who should be held accountable vis-a-vis possible negative implications. To sum up, technologies are designed to solve some issues in society, but they end up being used for different purposes, and as such, having unwanted and unintended impacts. How can scientific foresight be used for anticipating hard and soft impacts? Here we present a framework consisting of 6 steps for the scientific foresight approach to be used in the European Parliament. Specifically, science foresight is the first attempt of the European Parliament to study possible long-term societal impacts of techno-scientific trends. Particularly relevant to the members of Parliament are the identification of techno-scientific topics relevant for the specific constituencies and the outcome of the foresight study, where future scenarios and legislative pathways are pointed out. We will illustrate some of these steps with examples related to 3D printing. A topic can be, for instance, a technology-related question with societal relevance, such as concerns or challenges related to energy security, an aging society, or the achievability of a circular economy. The key European value that the Parliament is enacting is democracy. Consequently, democracy also plays a relevant role as a guiding principle for our methodology framework. Topics for scientific foresight studies in the EP need to be of concern and relevance to the broader interests of the wider European public. The second step in our analysis is to scan the so-called technological horizon. At this stage, technical experts will unravel the complexity of the topic by conducting a technology assessment study, identifying plausible trends in existing discussions on the given techno-scientific trend, and considering a wide range of impacts. In order to analyze the impacts, we compiled a checklist summarized in the acronym STEPID. This stands for Social, Technological, Economic, Environmental, Political, Legal, Ethical, and Demographic Aspects. 3D printing of human organs is a promising scientific and technological development. We speak about 3D printed kidneys, livers, and even hearts. Latest developments demonstrated that it's even possible to 3D print capillary veins. Most notably, an important positive impact is that organs can be printed from the patient's own stem cells, by which the risk of tissue rejection is low or non-existent. But as you know, 3D has a much wider area of application, covering 3D objects of all sizes. As an example, let's take the case of 3D printed guns. The guns you see on this slide were all capable of firing bullets. One of these was even produced with a home-built 3D printer of less than 500 euro. The third step presupposes 360-degree envisioning, which is a typical foresight phase. In this phase, social scientists and humanities scholars are playing a key role as they will scrutinize the horizon scan with technical experts. In particular, 360-degree envisioning intends to identify and challenge horizon scanning assumptions, which are often taken as implicitly true. Although technologies strive to offer answers to societal needs, they often give rise to unintended outcomes that pose different impacts. While considering it, the 360-degree envisioning ensures that all of society is taken into account. In this context, experts consider a wide set of plausible to possible impacts, including not intended and less expected impacts. An example of a non-intended impact, which might be overlooked in technical horizon scanning, concerns users' private values. For instance, driverless cars have been enthusiastically welcomed, yet technical horizon scanning has failed to consider that some of us love driving our cars. In order to ensure that society as a whole has been inclusively considered in the assumptions and the impacts of possible future trends, we again go to STEPID. We look especially into all the different societal parameters, including age, gender, origin, religion, profession, abilities, disabilities, skills, education, income level, and other parameters that might be relevant for the subject of the study. By considering demographics-related impacts, we ensure a full 360-degree approach. This type of analysis allows for social scientists to scrutinize technical impacts, focuses on possible impacts, and deals with the values of all societal players and stakeholders. Now we come to the fourth step, which is scenario development, where the results are used to describe events and trends as they could evolve based on alternative assumptions on how these events and trends may influence the future. And now we come to the key step for a legislative body such as the European Parliament, namely connecting the future with the present by carrying out a legislative horizon scan. Legislative backcasting aims at identifying areas for action in order to support certain scenarios and suppress unwanted consequences. The outcome of the backcasting phase is to create legislative pathways able to anticipate future impacts, for instance, raising awareness for specific issues during the agenda-setting process may open legislative pathways for the members of the Parliament. In the case of 3D printing technology, we can imagine a lot of legislative areas to be relevant, such as safety, consumer protection, intellectual property rights, environment, functioning of markets, employment, and investments. The last phase is about making sense of foresight results, where the obtained insights and knowledge about the futures are translated into results with a pragmatic character for the MEPs. The aim of this step is to engage MEPs in the results of the scientific foresight studies and thereby gain their responsiveness. In doing so, we combine technical, social, and legal knowledge and expertise developing futures in line with ethical, political, and other preferences. As for a foresight communication strategy, we have several possibilities in mind. Along with meetings and presentations, our strategies also include face-to-face discussions with members. As a follow-up, we firmly believe that an important part of the foresight cycle is to measure the impacts of provided knowledge on parliamentary activities, for assessing their usability by the members, and for evaluating the methods used. In parallel with performing foresight exercises following the aforedescribed protocol, we will conduct awareness-raising activities. This will be done by regularly producing what-if publications on scientific trends. So what's in this approach for the members? The foresight cycle presents several relevant points for MEPs. First, members choose which technology-related questions will be analyzed, being fully involved in defining the foresight agenda. Second, members will have a considerable understanding of what possible future scenarios and trends may be. Technological developments and possible consequences are also included in foresight activities. And third, based upon preferences, MEPs could derive legislative pathways towards the most desirable future. Informed, reliable, and solid decisions during parliamentary work is enabled by the scientific and transparent evidence of foresight studies. In short, the scientific foresight approach integrates futures studies and technology assessment approaches with developments in emerging domains of knowledge such as science and technology studies and ethics of technology, to help the MEPs be better prepared for unexpected and unintended societal impacts of techno-scientific trends. We can conclude by saying that scientific foresight studies offer the best tools to create globally and individually desirable futures by anticipating possible impacts of techno-scientific trends with today's legislative actions. Thank you for your attention.